the head. It's a flourish, and he steals from Jaworski. Up he goes.
Another save. He picks his spot.
And he blocks Jaworski, but draws a foul. You can almost expect that Pinoy face is like a volcano. The foolish thing, but the flourish will come when you want it. We have time to give you my time.
Time left, 2:53, and we have Crispa hosting for the second time the 15-point lead. Continues to be a nightmare from the line.
Boy, they've missed four opportunities in their last four shots from the charity strike.
Incidentally, on the delayed telecast, any game between Gilpie's Gimlet and Great Base has to be super. And this game was no exception. The game equaled the conversion high with the team combining for 287 points. Both imports played to the maximum, with Matthew scoring 65 points on 70% shooting. And as an added treat, Danny Poblano also had an interview with superstar Nora Nora at halftime. Thank you, enjoy.
We have Ed Cordero in the game now for the Toyota team. Ed is a very good three-point shooter. Ed Ocampo realizes that this game is very far away and he needs a three-point shot.
Well, here's a treat here, import versus import. Ed Ocampo asking Julius Wade to keep an eye on Wade. He intercepts the play. Continues to struggle, and that's our bubbles. A minute and 45.
Big 15-point lead posted by the Crispa Redmanizers, and they really wore down the Toyota team. They wore them down to the ground.
Outside call gets fouled by Julius Wayne. And Julius Wayne just got his third personal foul, bringing Toyota to the 14th foul with a minute and 39. The fans can smell blood. They know what to leave. So they stand up, and Crispa heading towards the 10th win versus one loss. And this is the reason why I did not believe. Abiosa inside, but gently following up. It's different. When Tommy Manoff said that the pressure was off, sure they lost to San Miguel, he was glad about that because the pressure was off. I think what really happened behind the scenes is that he hyped the drill and tightened the defense and the shooting power of the Redmanizers. I think they really worked overtime.
Yes, I think that loss had a very good effect for the Crispa team. They were no longer thinking about the consecutive victories. They were more concentrated with playing good ball.
Open. We have 23 seconds. It's a one. 7 wins off the offense. Upper hand being enjoyed by the Redmanizers, and Cordero goes to the line and was fouled in the act of shooting. It is a foul call against SR.
Let's take a look at the players that really got playing time from Coach Tommy Minotto. You have Philip Spencer, Cardiff Israel, Arthur Cole, Freddy Gubalde, you know, the local players that are on the court now. You also have Villamin, Igabin, Varela. They had about 7 or 8 players that shared the playing time for the Crispa Redmanizers.
And they did also have their part. And this is a bugger pulls from left to right, back and forth, to stop him. You know that he can hit maybe 7 or 11 points. And we have a rainbow shot from Cordero. Officially, at the end of this contest, we have Crispa under 24 and